Welcome unto mercy. Welcome unto blessings. Welcome unto mercy. Welcome unto blessings. Welcome unto repentance. Welcome unto forgiveness. Welcome unto repentance. Welcome unto forgiveness.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله كما علمنا ونحمد. والصلاة والسلام على أشرف خلق سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. ربنا أخرجنا من ظلمات الوهم وأدخلنا في نور العلم وجمل أخلاقنا بالحلم. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى يا رب العالمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وعنده مفاتح الغيب لا يعلمها إلا هو ويعلم ما في البر والبحر وما تسقط من ورقة إلا يعلمها ولا حبة في ظلمات الأرض ولا رطب ولا يابس إلا في كتاب مبين. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. ثم أما بعد, my brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah, as brother Ahmed already highlighted and as every one of you already of course preparing for the last 10 days of Ramadan. وقالوا العبرة بخواتم الأمور. العبرة في الأمور بخواتمها. He said the criteria is by the finish. How you finish. But this doesn't mean that the beginning is not important. In fact, to position yourself for a strong finish, you need to have a strong foundation and strong start. When you have a good start, planned start, structured start, positive and strong start, this, mashallah, position you for a good, successful finish. So, alhamdulillah, I hope that every one of us, inshallah, has got or already did a strong start, so that we are positioned now for a strong finish. And the finish, the whole, this is what matters. How you finish, even as the hadith says, how the person finishes his life is what matters. A person may do all bad deeds in his life, but then if he, before he dies, did the tawbah, returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with sincerity, started to do his best, and he dies, all the tawbah from the kaba'ir and from what he's done will be wiped out. All the bad stuff will be wiped out and still will become like a baby. And then he goes straight to Jannah. فالعبرة بالأمور بخواتمها. This doesn't mean again that you play and come at the end and you do good, because how do you know when it is your end? You can end any time. That's why you need to be always cautious. وَمَنْ شَابَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ شَابَ عَلَيْهِ وَمَنْ شَابَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ مَاتَ عَلَيْهِ فِي الْغَالِبِ. مَنْ شَابَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ فِي الْغَالِبِ شَابَ عَلَيْهِ. وَمَنْ شَابَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ فِي الْغَالِبِ مَاتَ عَلَيْهِ. Whoever grew up on something, usually or often, that's how he will become, يعني in his youth, how you are in youth, this is will be like your old age, in Shabab and Shiba. And then if you grew up with a particular يعني way, this is usually this is how you'll finish as well. That's why it is important to at young age start doing the right thing right. Continue. Because of two things. One is you don't know when you're going to finish. Death comes anytime. It comes and takes babies, takes people 5 years old, 10 years old, 50, 60, 40, 30, 20, sports people, healthy, sick, everyone. Death does not differentiate. It can come at any time to any person, basically. So you don't know when you're going to finish. So that's why at young age, whatever your age is, قال وقال الإمام الغزالي رحمه الله من بلغ الأربعين ولم يغلب خيره شرا فليتجهز إلى النار. Whoever reached 40 and his good deeds do not outweigh the bad deeds, let him prepare himself for hellfire. This is not a rule, This is in general. But of course, there are exceptions. There are lots of people who did tawbah at the end, and alhamdulillah, Allah inshallah accept their tawbah. And also, doesn't mean that for us, if you are 40, it is too late. No, Imam Ghazali is saying this for just one purpose, to warn those who are growing up and did not yet think of tawbah, to deter them from the bad deeds. Doesn't mean that they are going to hellfire or anything like that. It just means to deter people from continuing being in the wrong path, to wake up, if you like. Finishing, let's finish strongly, inshallah. فَالْعِبْرَ بِخَوَاتِمِهَا وَعَلَمُوا. And I will finish with this. Know my brothers, انتبهوا. Be careful what I'm going to say. أعلموا أن ليس الغرض وليس المقصد من السحابة الإمطار ولكن المقصد منها وجود الإثمار. Key thing. ليس الغرض من السحابة الإمطار ولكن الغرض منها وجود الإثمار. The purpose or the whole objective of a cloud is not to rain. لا, but for the fruits, to get out the fruits. What is the purpose of your mobile phone? What is the purpose of having a mobile phone? To call?
Communicate.
To communicate and deliver a message. Not just to have iPhone 5, those kids who just they have iPhone, i4s, and so they need i5. Why do you need an i5? It's cool, it's the latest version. No. You don't need iPhone because the latest version. This is not the maqsid of the iPhone. This is not the maqsid of the telephone, the mobile phone. What is the purpose of sowing seeds? Is the purpose of sowing seeds to have trees? No. The purpose of sowing seeds is to get the fruits of the trees to eat. This is what is the purpose. Right? So the purpose of the cloud, أَلَيْسَ الْغَرْضُ مِنَ السَّحَابَةِ الْإِمْطَارُ, that you to get the rain. لا, the غرض of the cloud, we'll be happy to have a cloud if we can drink from the rain coming from the cloud and to water our trees to get the fruits. So the hope, what does it mean? The fruits. The fruits is the maqsid. Not the actual tree, not the cloud, not the rain coming from the cloud. Careful with this. So what is the maqsid of the 10 days of tahajjud and qiyam and even your siyam and all ibadat? The maqsid is not the ibadah itself. The maqsid is not to just come and line up. The maqsid is not just to fast. This is like the cloud and the rain and the water. The maqsid is the fruits of this ibadat on your heart. How you reflect on your behavior as a Muslim, on your attitude as a Muslim. So make this name, make this objective why I'm here. Not just to line up, not to tell my dad that I came to Taraweeh or to show my friends that I'm here in Taraweeh. Taraweeh, it is important, it's like the cloud, like the rain. But the maqsid, how it is going to reflect on the iman on your heart, in your heart. Yaqeen in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tawakkul in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How you manage your relationships with others, with the fellow Muslims, and even the non-Muslims. Do you have husn al-dhann and su' al-dhann? Will after the i'tikaf and the 10 days and this, will you have husn al-dhann, positive thinking of your brother, or will you continue to have su' al-dhann, negative thinking? Someone gave you an appointment and he didn't show up. The first time, straight away, he's a bad person, he does not respect, and you just open fire on him. Or you say, maybe give him an excuse, maybe he was sick, maybe something happened, maybe this, maybe that. And you give a promise. Is it really important for you to fulfill your promise or not? When you do something, would you really do it with perfection or not? And dealing with my brothers and sisters, we have just 1 minute left. Dealings, adab al-suhba, the dealings, who is the being that is most deserving our husn al-suhba, the best of companionship, best of company, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as you look after your dealings with your brothers and relatives and colleagues at work, etc., know that there is someone who is closer, who does not leave you. Even your wife, you leave your wife for a while and you go to work and you're not dealing with her. But there is someone 24 hours a day, 60 minutes, 60 seconds, a minute, and less than that, you are with him. هو صاحبك ومولاك سيدك ومولاك الذي لا يفارقك لحظة في لا في نومك ولا في قرآنك ولا هو معك في كل خطواتك وخطراتك ولحظاتك وأنفاسك. So have the best company with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's with you all the time. You are dealing with him all the time, with every breath. When you deal with me, when you deal with your wife, with your children, with your parents, with your colleagues, you are dealing with them, yes, but who am you are really dealing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So deal with everyone and know that you are dealing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through this person. You are not actually dealing with the person, this is the fruit, this is the max. So watch out how to get the fruits in your life. If at the end of those 10 days or this month, you didn't find fruits, my suggestion to you, you have to stop and check yourself. This is, I'm saying it in the most lenient way. You have to stop and check yourself. You have worked hard and no fruits. Something is wrong, right? Something is wrong. You must find an effect of this. You must touch and feel and taste a fruit of this ibadah this month. If it didn't happen, trust me, you have to check yourself. Check your heart, do what you can. How to get the fruits of things? This is what we call the inner dimension of the ibadah. Even I started on the Muslim Aid Australia website, started lectures, short ones, each one is like 3-4 minutes, about just the zakah side of things. The zakah is an ibadah. But it, again, is the purpose of zakah just to pay? No. The purpose of zakah is to find the fruits of the zakah in your life. How to find it and reap this fruit and taste it in your life. So it turns out to be from giving, actually taking. You find that actually giving the zakat, in fact, in reality, it is taking, not giving. Likewise, the siyam, salat, tahar, every ibadah. It is about taking, about finding fruits in your life. How to do this, inshallah, in HDMS after Ramadan, we'll have a series of lectures. I've been actually doing it for the last 3 years, studying and focusing. I've been not doing anything except focusing. My main focus in the last 3 years was how to get the fruits of the ibadah in our life. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقول رسالتكم محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.